is the house between Espinel and the tower at 1155. And he's turned down that development, okay, to join that piece. There's a piece where here it is titled in your home. It is.
Can we talk about that? Kelly, you might have to speak for a minute.
Okay, we'll let you finish up. I mean, I think we're going to discuss this again in the next Wednesday.
Here's the issue. This is my property. I want to decide what I can do with my property. That's the issue. You're not deciding what I should do with my property. You can't tell me, well, you're still okay with the same gene. No, I can't accept that.
I want to go with a few points, Council President, if you don't mind.
Steep slopes. That makes me laugh. All the buildings are steep slopes. Did you have a landslide under the river? Can you find a landslide under the building? No. The only landslide that was there was the sewage. And it was up in the field. It'd be better off if there was a building on top. It was just used as an excuse to push your rocks. The landslides. One sewage problem. No more. There are no more landslides. It's a natural occurrence on empty slope. So let's just say some fact that steep slopes are not a problem for developments. Up in all over the world, buildings go up all over the world. Upside down. Steep slopes are not an issue. The other issue was neglected. It was all bogus. This is a whole bogus thing. It angers me that you guys go to great lengths to further your cause. You don't want to take this land. Does it affect you? Why would you take pleasure or pride out of the fact that you said it? You have nothing to do with those things. First of all, let me move on to the points I really have to say. Traffic is not. I walked to the train. 8 minutes. Two issues that you had said I want to address. I walked to the train 8 minutes. 8.5 minutes. From the top of the wall to 8 minutes. I'm going to be in a car. When I drive to work, traffic's not an issue. I do not have any delays. Now, I do want to recap the things that I can't. The letter I sent this morning commented on some issues that were raised on meeting with 14. You know, we as owners of the lots involved had little time to prepare because we were unaware of initiatives taken to rezone above 10-1057 Warburton Avenue. The more days go by, the more upset we get. How on earth does this bogus rezoning squeak by up until this point? Have we lost our minds? The rezoning proposal now only applies to a few properties to benefit a few. Now, in the letter today, let me be clear, because most of the public that was here on the 14th did not understand. Lots from 1057 to 1155, including Randy and Ginsburg, are not affected. So now, to throw a bone to a few activists, that the last few lots, including ours, need to be rezoned for what purpose? Can anybody explain it to us? Because this relationship really stinks. We don't understand it. We can't see the reason of it. I'm 50 years old this year, and I cannot get it. It's unbelievable. And I want to briefly touch on the points that we already have made, but I want to repeat it, because probably it's the last time we're allowed to speak. It is substantial loss of value on our investment in the Zone A area. We bought the Zone A area. I want to keep my options open. This rezoning is meaningless as it does not address the original complaints of the residents of 1085. And it seems like that this rezoning of this tiny fraction of Warburton is just to keep some people quiet. The message is, don't invest in Yonkers because we can spot zone you anytime, anywhere. This rezoning better than just the properties. How does the proposed rezoning of these few lots? Let me repeat that, wasn't very clear. This rezoning benefits only a few properties across the street. Recent construction mishaps require a change in management, not a change in zoning. Building on steep slopes, so is the race on 1085 to the river on 1155. All over the world, buildings go up on any terrain. Landslides we use as an excuse to uphold zone A. When properly developed, there will be no landslides. Any landslides under high-density buildings? No, none. Only one in open stretch of land. This is just a case of residents of high-density buildings not wanting to lose the views because of another high-density building. Finally, this area is designated as a high-density area, and most buildings have been built or approved already. What's the point to rezone now to benefit a few? And as a result, we are the victims of this in a very un-American way, and a property value will dramatically be reduced. And how are we going to compensate?
I think you've raised a lot of points and some of those questions that we have to answer. And we focused the 15 minutes before us to see about it. I think we're going to move this to continue this discussion for those things. And I